Oi, tudo bem? Aqui é a Luciana da Street Smart Brazil. Today we're going to have a vocabulary lesson and you're going to learn about things that are in the kitchen. So what's in this lesson? 46 things in the kitchen in Portuguese and pronunciation tips so you can pronounce the words correctly and speak beautiful Portuguese. So what I did to help you is the stressed syllable of each word. Which is the strongest syllable when you pronounce a word is underlined. So I hope this is gonna help you as a guide, as a pronunciation guide. And I would like to ask you to please like the video if you've been learning Portuguese with us, subscribe to the channel. These are great ways to support us. I really appreciate it. Muito obrigada. I will read each word in Portuguese twice. I'm not going to read the article, but I put it there so you can see whether the word is feminine or masculine. So here's our first word, cozinha, cozinha. And here we have the sound of the NH at the end of the word. It is similar to the N tilde in Spanish and the GN in Italian. Of course, the purists will say it's not the same, but I think it's a really good way to bring the NH in Portuguese to your awareness if you know Spanish or Italian. So these are approximations to help you get the sound. Or in English, you can think of NYA as in Enya, the singer, if you pronounce it softly. In the masculine syllable, you can think of Kenyan. So these are just approximations to help you understand what the NH is in Portuguese. So let's say this again. Cozinha. Cozinha, garfo, garfo, faca, faca, colher, colher. So here we have the LH. Again, these are only approximations. It will sound kind of like the double L in Spanish in parts of the Spanish speaking countries, or the GL in Italian. In English, you can think of million. Or you can think of, you know, like when you say yo, yo, put an L in the beginning, yo. Just ways to help you see what the LH sounds like in Portuguese. And here it is again, talheres, talheres, porta, talheres, porta, talheres, colher de pau, colher de pau, espátula, espátula, prato, prato, tigela, tigela. I have a lesson on the pronunciation of the letter G in Portuguese because sometimes it's a hard G and sometimes it's not, like in tigela. So check out my lesson, pronunciation of the letter G. Pires, pires. This word has an interesting thing. It ends in an S, so it sounds like it's plural, but it's not. It's actually the same word for singular. As you can see, the article is in the singular, o pires, but it's the same word for the plural, os pires, so it doesn't change. A xícara, xícara. And in that word, we have the pronunciation of the X as the first letter of the word. The X will have different sounds, okay? So this is when it is the first letter of the word. And it's like the SH in English. So it's an easy sound. We have the word xícara, we just saw it. And this is a really good way to compare sounds because the way we pronounce the name of the company here in Brazil is Xerox. So look at the first X, right? Not the last one, which is different. Xerox. And we have the word xadrez that we can see in a chess game, jogo de xadrez, or also in patterns, right? Like this shirt, camisa xadrez. Copo, copo. Taça, taça. Caneca, caneca. Louça, louça. Lavar a louça. I thought it would be useful to know how to say to do the dishes. Lavar a louça. And you will also hear people saying lavar os pratos. which literally means to wash the plates, but of course we mean the dishes, everything. Máquina de lavar louça. Máquina de lavar louça. And you will also see lava louças. Lava louças. Especially if you're looking to buy one online, that's the word most stores will use, lava louças. But most of them will have it in the feminine with feminine articles and pronouns, but in the dictionary it is masculine. Armário. Armário. Balcão. Balcão. Fogão. Fogão. Forno. Forno. Forno micro-ondas. Forno micro-ondas. And oftentimes we really just say micro-ondas. Panela. Panela. Tampa da panela. Oftentimes we just say tampa, right? Lid. But the whole thing is tampa da panela. Frigideira. Frigideira. Geladeira. Geladeira. There is another word for refrigerator. Refrigerador. Refrigerador. Congelador. Congelador. And you know, this is the old style of refrigerators, right? But today in Brazil, we also talk about freezer and we use the same word and we use it much more often than congelador. Garrafa. Garrafa. I have a lesson on the pronunciation of the R in Brazilian Portuguese. We have different sounds for it, so go check my lesson. Garrafa. Chaleira. Chaleira. Here we have the CH. The CH in any part of the word, it sounds like the SH in English. Chave. Chuva. Cafeteira. Cafeteira. For those of you who like French press coffee, prensa francesa. Prensa francesa. Bule. Bule. Torradeira. Torradeira. Liquidificador. Here the tip is to not say key in the QUI, don't say key. Liquidificador. Pia. Pia. Torneira, torneira, escorredor de pratos, escorredor de pratos, escorredor de macarrão, escorredor de macarrão, despensa, despensa, tábua de cortar, tábua de cortar, ralador, ralador, avental, avental. To practice your new vocabulary, you could have a cooking date with Brazilian friends or a Brazilian partner if you have one, and just make a plan that all the cooking is going to be done in Portuguese, maybe even the cooking and the eating. Just make sure this is not a moment to be stressed out about remembering words or pronouncing it perfectly. It's a moment to have fun and learn. We offer one-on-one Brazilian Portuguese lessons via Skype. You know, the best way to learn is really one-on-one because it's all about you. And our teachers are very well trained to help you speak Portuguese with ease and confidence. So visit us at streetsmartbrazil.com, book a trial lesson to see how we can help you advance your Portuguese. Muito obrigada for watching this lesson. Tchau, tchau.